Value Seekers, I'm Nick. Right now, the talk of the town is Threadripper 2. So, naturally, Noctua sent us their NHU14S TR4 SP3 CPU air cooler for the TR4 socket to check out and put through its paces in our typical gear-seeking fashion. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that button right now and turn on that little bell to receive notifications. We upload multiple times per week, so make sure you're subscribed. Now, I've been daily driving a Threadripper 1950X for a few months now, and one of the things I've noticed with the chip is it can run very, very hot, and especially when you're doing real world things like video editing and rendering, which is mainly what I use my Threadripper system for. In this video, we're gonna see if the Noctua NHU14S is up to the task and if you should consider buying it if you're thinking of switching over to Threadripper 2. Because we're a smaller channel, AMD didn't send us any of the new CPUs, so our 1950X will have to do for now. So everything we talk about in this video from here on out is 1950X related. All right. First off, let's see what's in the box and what you get for your hard-earned money and take a little physical look at the cooler before we talk about those numbers. Alrighty, let's unbox the NHU14S. As you can see here, this is the cooler. The fan is 140mm and it comes with one fan pre-installed. Now, before we look at the cooler, let's see what you get with it accessory-wise. This is the box that it comes in. Let's pop it open and see what's inside. So the first thing you're gonna see is the manual, and this shows you how to install it. Now these are some vibration pads if you choose to install another fan. This is pretty much everything else you need. Additional clips for additional fans, thermal paste, and a resistor to make the fan spin slower if that's your jam. In my case, I am just going to use the motherboard fan speed control for that. And lastly, an Allen key to fasten it to your motherboard and to change the offset of the cooler itself. I'll show you how that works in a moment. Let's take a closer look at the cooler itself. Now, it is very, very big. However, it's not as heavy as you think it would probably be. So yeah, let's slide it out. Any minute now, Nick. And let's take a closer look. The heat plate has been specifically designed for a TR4 or Threadripper CPU. So the heat plate is absolutely huge. It is a lot bigger than a typical CPU cooler. Now, depending on your motherboard and your GPU, you can actually change the cooler's offset so it doesn't hit whatever you've got populating the top PCIe slot on your motherboard. And basically what you do is you loosen the screws and change the offset. Yeah, I didn't need to change the offset with my setup, so I won't be changing it here. All right, let's spin the cooler around nice and slow so you can have a look at how well this cooler is constructed. It is made so very, very well. One thing I wanted to mention about this cooler as well before we continue is it is very, very quiet. The installation is very straightforward. So straightforward and easy that I didn't film it because it's literally four screws and takes no more than 2 minutes to get the job done. So bonus points already for being just really, really easy to install. I tested this on my own personal editing rig. This is the rig I'm currently editing this video on right now as well. Let's talk about some of the specs of the system before we move on. The CPU, as mentioned before, is the Threadripper 1950X on the ASRock X399 Professional Gaming running BIOS version 3.2, which is the newest BIOS revision at time of filming this video. The memory is running with XMP enabled as well at 3000 megahertz. The system is in the Cooler Master Cosmos C700P. If you want to check out the original build video for that system, there is a little eye in the top right hand corner right now, and you can check that out at your own convenience. So I only have one other TR4 compatible cooler, and yeah, we're gonna use that to compare against the NHU14S, and that is the Cooler Master ML240L with the TR4 bracket.
For these tests, we let the system idle for 20 minutes with each cooler installed to get a proper idle temperature, and we used the IDA 64 stress test for 20 minutes with each cooler so we could get a proper set of temperatures for a fully loaded CPU. At idle with the Cooler Master ML240L, we see the maximum temperature spike up to 46.1C with an average of 35.5C. At idle with the Noctua NHU14S, we see the maximum temperature spike up to 43.5C with an average of just 34C. At full load in IDA 64 with the Cooler Master ML240L, we see an average temperature of 66.1C with a maximum temperature of 66.6C. Sounds pretty evil, right? Now, here's a surprise for me and something that I wasn't expecting. Well, to be honest, I didn't know what to expect. At full load in IDA 64 with the Noctua NHU14S, the average temperature was 56.7C with a maximum temperature of 57.5C. That's almost a 10 degree difference, which is crazy. And in cooling performance, that's the difference between thermal throttling and maximum performance. I'll just add this in as well. I didn't really test this, but it was something that I did notice. When I was playing Quake Champions with the Cooler Master ML240L, the 1950X would boost up to around about 3.7 gigahertz, hitting around 60 degrees. And yeah, with the NHU14S, the 1950X was boosting to over 4 gigahertz and not getting hotter than 40 degrees. That's incredible. So at the end of the day, would I recommend the Noctua NHU14S TR4 for your Threadripper system? Well, put it this way, the numbers don't lie. It's an absolute beast of a cooler. And to be honest, I'm not going back to an AIO in my daily driver. The Noctua NHU14S is here to stay. And with that said, we're awarding the Noctua NHU14S TR4 SP3 the Gearseeker's Gear of Approval for Best Performance Air Cooler for Threadripper. Surprise, surprise. What I can't say is though, is how well it will perform on the 2990WX and the 2970WX right now, because yeah, I don't have one. And yeah, I can't make those assumptions, but what I can say is for the 2950X and the 2920X, it will be perfect considering the TDP of both of those CPUs are exactly the same as the 1950X. If you're interested in grabbing one of these coolers, there is a link in the description down below. Right now, they're going for around about $79 on Amazon, which is an absolute steal. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you didn't like this video, you know what to do and tell us what you didn't like about it. Tell us what we did wrong. Just tell us anything down below. Once again, thanks so much for watching. I'm Nick with Gearseekers. You peak, we seek. And I'm gonna go and edit this video with this new cooler installed because it is actually freaking impressive. Good work, Noctua. Thank you.